Ligachiga 1, I mean, it's been a while since I posted some Assassin's Creed. I decided to do a little update video. I'm not sure if you can hear the game at all, but yeah, I'm playing NukeTown Zombies Call of Duty Black Ops 2. What are the odds? Yeah, I got the Care Package Edition, and right now I have the T-shirt cannon I'm running on NukeTown. This is pretty cool, actually. I really like the idea of NukeTown, but I haven't come to talk about it. I'll talk about it when I do, like, a video of it. I've just been wanting to know if any of you guys wanted a video. Like, see, there's a T-shirt cannon. It's actually the war machine, but I call it the T-shirt cannon. That's what I called it. You know, I called it in front of my friends and everything. I'm not sure if anyone in any videos, you know, thought of that name. That's just what it feels like, because, you know, like, it doesn't do anything. Look, see, the T-shirt or grenade, whatever you want to call it, because it doesn't explode automatically. It just goes off into, like, the distance or whatever. It's like, you get a T-shirt, and you get a T-shirt, and you get a T-shirt. I'll just name this video the creation of the T-shirt cannon. I don't know. I was just playing, you know, a game by myself, and I just thought of, hey, this kind of looks like a cannon that shoots T-shirts. That's pretty much all it came out to be. I mean, yeah, I'm hidden there, and I also have the Python, too, but this is what I got from the box. I mean, I can get the Galvaknuckles right now, but I don't feel like it. So, what I was gonna say about Assassin's Creed, it's been Thanksgiving break, and Black Friday was yesterday. I got the iPod Touch 5th generation. I'd post a picture if I knew how to, like, you know, cut the video and show a little picture. I'll probably just ask my friend if he could teach me how to do that real quick. But, anyways, so yeah, I've had a good Black Friday, good Thanksgiving week. How about you guys? No? Alright, cool. I had a little scare the other day. I had, what was it? I logged into YouTube and I saw my comments, and I usually have, you know, one here and there from friends or just a random person I know. And it said I had 182 comments. 182. I was wondering where the heck that came from, because, you know, I never get, you know, enough content to post that many or have them. Oh, shoot. Cool guys don't look at explosions. But to have that many, like, comments and stuff. So that was just really weird. By the way, this is like round 9 and Jug already spawned, so I think this is going to be a long game. I'm not going to record the whole thing, but I'll record one eventually. As long as you guys want to watch it, I'll record one. I mean, you guys, I don't know. Whoever's watching this, this is the creation of the T-shirt cannon, officially owned by Ligachico. I make it sound like officially copyright. If anyone uses T-shirt cannon, I'll sue him. Alright, let's just open up the middle here. As you can see, there's a the Galvaknuckles right there. Okay, take the T-shirt cannon. Yeah, I mean, I don't even know how I'm doing this. This is just like, I'm sorry, I was going in the circle. That was close. I was going in a circle at the beginning. I really like this map because, you know, the characters in it aren't cussing. There's no, because you're either a CIA man or, what was it? The Nuke people? I don't know. I really don't know the official name. So it's just really interesting. And plus, I also have, Theory locked, you know, that's this clock has nothing to do with when perks spawn. Nothing. Because when Juggernaut spawned, that I wasn't killing anything. It's that counter is just, you know, just for you killing zombies. The clock will go up every time you kill a zombie. And yeah, it has nothing to do with your perk. I think there, yeah, what was it? No, it wasn't Juggernaut. It was when Pack-a-Punch spawned. I started hearing sirens. I wasn't killing anything, so that's when I figured it out. So anyone wanted to know that, you're welcome. If this video helped you at all, you know, leave a like or favorite, whatever. I always have Assassin's Creed. I'm gonna be posting more. I have, like, up to video 17 recorded. So yeah, I'll probably be posting those, like, next. Wait, what the hell? Oh, that was quick revive. Okay, yeah. But I'll be posting more. You know. It's only 4 minutes. Jeez. I feel like you guys need a little video, but yeah, so, I'll probably put a thing at the beginning, you know, skip to the middle of the video to find out when, what happens with that. So that theory is broken. I would have shown a video, but I wasn't recording at the time, so yeah. Oh, by the way, this is a really good, like, area kind of to run, having that open. And that crawl right there. Oh yeah, and the reason I've kind of been gone, or not talking or anything, or just not posting videos, is because I've been watching a lot of Doctor Who. I started, yeah, New Maximum. But I started on season one of the new 2005 seasons, and I'm already on season five, Christmas special. I actually have that on my computer right now. I haven't been playing, or I mean, not playing, but watching it right now. But yeah, I've been getting into it. It's really nice. Here, I'm gonna get. I'll keep the t-shirt cannon just for you guys, because I know there's probably gonna be, lovers at the t-shirt cannon. They're always gonna be like, "Oh my god, I love the t-shirt cannon." That was a really bad impression of you. Don't quote me on that. That is not how any of you sound. Don't take that as anything. But yeah, this has been a really good, thing. What was it? Bowie knife is now, useless. Galley knuckles, yes. Galley knuckles are good until, round 14. First, the closest possible round I've been able to get them at is round 8. So you guys can quote me on that. You're able to get galley knuckles at round 8. I'm gonna put that in the name of the video, how to get galley, or what's the lowest round you can get galley knuckles. That's the lowest round I've got it at. So, yeah. Oh yeah, and the counter has nothing to do with it. Like here, see 20, and I'll make it 19. 19, and that counter is supposed to go like that. Mushroom cloud? I'm not sure because my friend didn't notice that. There's a mushroom cloud on this level. Really cool. This NukeTown is really, really cool. I guess it's an overall view of the NukeTown this video is gonna be called. I don't know. But yeah, that's what's been going on. I know I've been talking like the whole video. This is not a post commentary, by the way. I'm playing right now. That's why I was saying, I'll just keep the t-shirt cannon for you guys. This thing is actually pretty awesome. I mean, when you upgrade it, they die on impact, so it's like really, really hard t-shirts. I don't know. But yeah, this is the soft t-shirts. Oh crap! Oh, that was close. Whoa! Okay, that's one kind of bad idea of my plan. This is kind of, my usual running spot. If you open up the stairs and don't open up these doors, zombies can't trap you by just running out. So that's a really good, strategy, just jumping down. You don't have to open the stairs yet to get down here. You can just fall down. And then, they can't get down from there. They'd have to go all the way down. So yeah, I mean, because usually if you have a friend down right here, the zombies just have to go all the way around because they're trying to follow the one that's up. And yeah. I really don't know. I think I'll finish this round. You guys get to see some zombie gameplay right now. And you see how the sound sounds, because I think you can hear me fine. I'm not sure if you can hear the TV fine. I've heard it on my Assassin's Creed videos. I'm really sorry about the sound. But yeah, more t-shirt cannon. T-shirts for everyone. T-shirt for you. You all get t-shirts. Lucky ducks. You get a t-shirt. And let me reload it like my Python. Oh yeah, these both reload like the same kind of way. I'll show. See how that reloaded, and I'll kill like a bunch of zombies with that, and it reloads kind of like that. So, yeah, Python is the smaller t-shirt cannon, and it does more damage. And there you go. See, and the clock, it just stroke zero, and it just makes that sound. It goes whoa. Unless you hear a siren, that's when the perks drop. Like, I'll show the perk. You're welcome. One side of Nuketown. This video has been 8 minutes. Wow, I feel like I've been talking a handful of Galley Knuckles. Oh, these things are sweet. Well, I'll show you one. Come on, buddy. See? Round 10, and that still is one hit kill. It's one hit kill until round 14. There's Juggernaut right here. Pack-a-Punch can also spawn. I think it's already spawned. Yeah, it is. It can spawn in really cool places. Like, Pack-a-Punch can spawn in really convenient or really cool, or it doesn't really matter. Max ammo? Sweet. So, I have max ammo on my t-shirt cannon. Let's go. Let's go. Vominos. I'm not gonna get the song stuck in your head. I'm sorry. Let's shoot that right there. Bounce back. And Pack-a-Punch. I don't know why it has a car battery on that. For some reason, Pack-a-Punch has a car battery. Watch, come here. Come here. Yeah, buddy. Come on. And all right, thank you for watching this video. Leave a like and a comment. And now it's back at 86. Leave a like, rate, comment, and that clock's over there. And I guess I'll see you guys in the next video, Assassin's Creed or Zombie Black Ops 2. And I'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching. Bye.